your various ways of affecting operations we have seen in the past lab. So various saving operations are, so we have seen circular tube, making a circular part to flat surface, and then from flat surface to external surface, etc. Okay. So different plane healing process also can be done by using shatter machine. So in the lab we have converted the circular part to square part, like that we can do by using shaping machine. Okay. So last class we have seen various operations performed with shaping machine. Okay. So what are the various mechanisms we use in shaping machine? What are the various mechanisms used in shaping machines? The first mechanism was cranked and started in the mechanism.
Workpiece will move
to and fro, and then initiating tool reciprocate, and then the planning what we see reciprocate. Here the shaping machine, somewhat small types of jobs can be machine. Somewhat small type of jobs can be machine. In planning, heavy workpieces can be machine. Heavy workpieces, heavier than that of the suppose big machine wise table, so like that big lathe bed. So lathe bed is easily you can do by using planning machine. Okay, lathe bed, you know the length of the workpiece will be 1 meter like that. Okay, very heavy length of workpieces will be done by using planning machine. Okay, and then so these are the so first two part is one is shaping machine, second is planning machine. Next third is what are the various reciprocating machine tools? So this is also drilling machine also comes under reciprocating tool. So drilling is you will fit the drill bit in the chucker, so automatically the drill bit will move. So by using manually, okay, by using manually what you can do now, the drilling operation you also do in the workplace. Okay, and then if you release the lever, automatically the tool will return to its home position. Okay. So this is also one type of reciprocating motion. Reciprocating motion, you know. Okay, reciprocating motion, just two and four motion will be there. So there are various types of drilling machine. So one is portable drilling machine. Okay, portable drilling machine, which can be moved from one place to another place. And then it can be moved from one place to another. That is small size. So otherwise you can be known as terrible drilling machine. The size will be this much. Okay, wherever you want to drill, you can bring them. Okay, binding shop also they may have use small drilling machine for punching. Okay, so they will drill easily and then they can for hook binding they can use them. Okay, and the hand drilling machine you may have seen in your home itself. Okay, suppose if you are to put one nail, automatically hand drilling machine you can insert, you can put hole and then you can insert the nut. Okay, hand drilling machine and the sensitive drilling machine and then radial drilling machine. Okay, radial drilling machine and then sensitive drilling machine. So these are the various types of drilling machines. Okay, so radial drilling machine, what is the need of radial drilling machine? So you can still like any axis. Suppose if you have to put a door vertical wall, okay, if you have to put the door in the vertical wall also, you can tilt that head, okay, tilt that head and then you can put the lead in the vertical wall, okay, so at any axis you can put the lead, okay, by using radial drilling, okay, and then next is reaming machine. Reaming is finishing operation of hole. So if you are drilling a hole, automatically you know that drill bit has some fluid. Okay, drill bit will be like this. Okay, the fluids will be there. Okay, through this fluid, what is the use of this fluid? So here only the material will cut and then the work piece will come outside in this fluid. Okay, fluid is nothing but a small groove present in the drill bit. Okay, what is the need of this groove? Opening. Okay, what is the need? In order to, if the workpiece is cut here, the burr will come which way? Through this way. It will come outside. Okay, so when the burr will come outside, what happens? The wall of the workpiece will not get finished. Okay, wall of the workpiece only, if you are, if drilling operation is done, if your finger, if you check the walls of the hole, what happens? Rough surface will be there. Understood? If you are drilling a workpiece now, if you check the walls of the workpiece now, what happens? Rough surface will be there. Okay, so in order to finish that, you can go for reaming operation. Okay, reaming operation, you can the cylindrical surface inside the hole. Okay, will be smooth. Your cylindrical surface will be smooth. inside the tool, if you are the first drilling operation has to be done. Next, if you are done draining operation, the surface will be smoother. Okay, compared to that of drilling operation. If you are done drilling, the surface will be harder. Okay. Next, boring operation enlarges the existing tool. Okay, boring operation is enlarging the existing tool. Enlarging the existing tools. So already tools will be there in order to enlarge them. Okay. So if there is no hole now, you directly want to put boring. Okay. Already there is hole now, you have to enlarge that. After that, you have to go for boring operation. Okay. Another last operation is tapping operation. So tapping operation are making internal thread. They are making internal thread. Suppose if you have to put a screw and then if you have to fix it, so in the tool what you have to do? By using reaming tool, if you are inserting that reaming tool, what happens now? Internal thread will be there. Okay, if you have to put the bolt in the car, you can directly put it by using the reaming tool. Okay, so these are the various reciprocating machine tools.